Rebels, another day with Unique Rebel here with Sarah with Unique Wellness Studio.
And the lovely Maria Angelova of Rebellious International.
Yes, we're excited to be here today on our topic today, Pilates, and particularly Rebellious Pilates.
Yep.
I just thought we should demystify some of how Rebellious Pilates, which is, I am certified on our Romana Krzyzanowska is a type of Pilates that it is, so it's more like classical Pilates, and how that's different than all of the other Pilates that's out there. And I'll ask Sarah, so when you first came to Pilates class, I guess, what did you expect and how was it different?
You know, I've taken Pilates classes at, you know, places where I've worked out. Mm-hmm. So the Pilates classes I took before I started practicing with Maria were in a class of probably the least 10 people, some classes as big as 25.
Mm-hmm.
I had zero idea what was going on, so I would tell you I didn't like Pilates.
Mm-hmm.
Because it was hard and I couldn't keep up and didn't know what the heck was going on.
That's kind of typical.
Mm-hmm.
So how was it different when you came here and what you experienced?
So we practice every Tuesday and Thursday,
mm-hmm.
and as much as possible that you can make that. There's 5 people in our class. I think maybe we've had 6 at one time.
Mm-hmm.
And it's different because Maria actually takes the time to show you how to do it. We never look as good as she does, but that's besides the point. To show
that
you,
is not true.
It is true.
You guys are looking a lot better now.
But you have seen her videos. I know you've seen them on Facebook. And every time she posts one, even though I've been taking Pilates with you for a year, I always do the wow emoji. It's gorgeous. Truly.
Thank you.
Gorgeous. But she teaches us how to do it in our bodies, how to feel it in our bodies. And she explains everything. And it is slow, but in a good way, and it's progressive. So you learn, you know, some foundational things, and then you build on that, and then you build on that to where, you know, there are things that I can do now. I would tell you I would first do seal, for example. I would never be able to do that. And it took some practice, commitment, consistency, and repetition.
Yes, repetitious words, that we say.
But I can do a lot of the things now.
Mm-hmm.
I never, you know, feel like I look as gorgeous as Maria doing it, but I'm doing it, and that's, I accept that, and I love it.
Yes,
yeah.
She looks great, by the way. But I think that's very important to talk about, because I think, especially for a practice like Pilates, precision is one of the principles of Pilates, and the small, detailed corrections are so important. And I think a lot of times, just like life, we go through the motions.
Mm-hmm.
And we're not focused on where should we be feeling it, where should we be lifting from, how should we be engaged. But we're just rushing from one exercise to the next. And that is something that, since I have taught even pre-Pilates, has been big for me, proper form. One, injury prevention. Two, especially in the case of Pilates, effectiveness of the workout. I mean, we have a lot of fun in class and we laugh about stuff,
mm-hmm.
because I didn't know, but I was famous with my digging my fingers into people's muscles.
You see Maria coming, you're like, oh, okay, I'm doing it right.
So I would just say, just lift from right here. And people will be like, oh, yes.
And believe me, you learn where right here is very quickly.
Yes.
Yes.
But then your
yes.
movement becomes better
yes.
and more effective, right?
Absolutely.
So I think it's also very interesting, the more you do it, so I always tell Pilates starts very like that. And then it kind of goes flat, flat. Oops, you have a moment where you're like, oh, I really feel that. And then you go like that, and then, oh, you have a moment. And Pilates gets harder and harder. Would you agree with that?
Mm-hmm, absolutely.
The more you do it. So what was it like? 3 weeks ago, I got a text from Sarah, and she's like, what did
oh,
we do
yeah.
yesterday? She's like, I can barely breathe. My abs are so sore. And we really didn't do that much different.
Mm-hmm.
We did the same thing. It's her.
Mm-hmm.
Her practice is getting deeper because
mm-hmm.
she's being consistent and she's showing up and listening and integrating what we're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
And as a result, her workout, her practice is becoming more powerful.
Mm-hmm.
And when I say powerful, I mean she's getting more out of it.
More out of it. Absolutely.
Yeah. So, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, I really wanted to talk about this
mm-hmm.
because new classes starting Monday and Wednesday for
That's
basics.
Right.
North Georgia School of Ballet starting April 8th, so Mondays and Fridays. join us. You know, we'll have a great time. And the group that we started with four dedicated ladies. Now we're like four, five, six. Mm-hmm. And it's, I mean, my goodness, the, you know, the change that you see mm-hmm. in those ladies, it's unbelievable.
Mm-hmm. And you know what, not only the Pilates and the change to that too, but you know, when talking about the retreat that we have coming up, there are a lot of reasons that people are coming to that retreat. There are a lot of reasons that we come to your Pilates yes. class. And one of the foundational reasons is to connecting with yes. other women, mm-hmm. like-minded people who, you know, are somewhere along the same lines as you are, interested in improving themselves and caring for themselves and showing up as better versions of themselves. We put all the technology gets put away, and for that hour, we are there in the room.
Just with ourselves. Yeah.
Connecting with each other and connecting through this beautiful practice. And if you have a way that you can invest in yourself, if you're ready for that commitment, I cannot encourage you enough to try Maria's classes out.
You
will not regret it, and it will exponentially improve your mental, physical, emotional, and spiritual selves.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yes. The mental piece, it's huge.
It's huge.
And when you can slow down, you don't have the loud music, the going quickly through the exercises, mm-hmm. and you feel your body. You know, one of our rules in class is you do what you can do. Don't watch your neighbor. And occasionally we'll pick on somebody, right?
Nicely.
Nicely, yes. We have a ton of fun. But it is amazing what that 1 hour of being focused on yourself will do for you.
And I think across the board, and I'm going to speak for everybody in that class, because I've heard us all say it at some point, is I didn't want to come this morning. I made myself get here. I had 200 other things to do. It ranges from that to I just didn't feel like it.
Right.
But we always feel better after class. Always, 100% of the time, better afterwards.
That means a lot. Mm-hmm. That's my baby. But I love it. And I love people who are committed. And, you know, like Sarah said, I have discovered that I truly love to work with people who are on their transformational paths and growing. Mm-hmm. And for them, this is more than just an hour of exercise. Mm-hmm. So, hope to see you in class in Pilates. Thank you, Sarah.
April
8th.
April 8th is the beginning.
Yes.
Recruit your butt and get yourself there.
Recruit your butt and get yourself in class. That is some of our secret terminology. You guys have a great day. Thanks for being with us.
Bye-bye. Bye.